Welcome back. Hello again, it's me, Taylor, and let's keep exploring the world of biology. In our biology journey, we've studied cells, and then we discovered that in most multicellular organisms, cells organize into tissues, which come together to form organs, which build body systems, which collectively make an organism. In this lesson, we'll explore a specific body system in humans, the circulatory system. In future lessons, we'll unpack other human organ systems. The circulatory or cardiovascular system includes our heart, blood vessels, and blood. Today, we will learn how our organs get the nutrients they need, how blood receives nutrients for transport, and how blood is moved throughout our body. If you're following along in your guided notes, pause this video to jot down your current best thinking about how our organs receive the nutrients they need. As you may remember from our lesson on the respiratory system, the circulatory system works to actually distribute the oxygen from the lungs to the cells of the body. To accomplish this, blood without oxygen moves toward the heart. Blood travels toward the heart in blood vessels called veins. From the heart, the blood is sent to the lungs to collect oxygen and drop off carbon dioxide waste. As we discovered in a previous lesson, these veins funnel into the tiny blood vessels called capillaries to interact with the alveoli of the lungs. Blood vessels that travel away from the heart are called arteries. Oxygenated blood travels throughout the majority of the body via arteries. When blood reaches its intended target, the arteries funnel into tiny capillaries, and the blood cells carrying oxygen drop off that oxygen and pick up carbon dioxide waste from other cells. After this gas exchange, the blood flows through veins that move back toward the heart, where the process repeats. In addition to this primary function, blood also transports other nutrients. Blood flows into capillaries around the digestive system to pick up nutrients from food and transport those nutrients all around the body. Blood also does other amazing things for our bodies. First, it drops some waste off at the kidneys for disposal through urine. Second, blood carries hormones throughout the body. Hormones are chemical messengers that regulate and signal all sorts of body processes, like stress, for example. And third, the circulation of blood helps to regulate body temperature. All of this blood flow is made possible by the central organ of the circulatory system, the heart, which is about the size of your fist. Some people argue about whether the heart is an organ or a muscle. It's actually both. The muscles of the heart allow it to forcefully push out blood to the rest of the body through arteries. Other muscles in the body and veins themselves help blood return to the heart via veins. The heart is split into four main chambers, which keep deoxygenated and oxygenated blood separate and allow the heart to move blood forward. Deoxygenated blood enters the right atrium of the heart and flows into the right ventricle. The right ventricle pumps the blood to the lungs to grab some oxygen. After receiving oxygen, the blood returns to the heart. The blood enters the left atrium and flows into the left ventricle, which pumps the blood out to the rest of the body. The atriums of the heart are thin tissues that just receive blood, but the ventricles are much thicker and actually pump the blood. The whole heart, like all other organs, is built of tissues, which are themselves built of cells. And like many organs, the heart is built of all four types of tissues. The heart's outermost tissue is connective fatty tissue that protects the heart. Moving inward, the next tissue is thick cardiac muscle tissue that allows the heart to do its pumping, followed by epithelial tissue that creates the inside of the heart, allowing blood to easily flow through it. The heart is also innervated with nerve tissue that regulates its heartbeat. Just like the heart, Blood vessels are built from tissues. Blood vessels are made of a thick wall of connective tissue, followed by layers of smooth muscle tissue, a bit more connective tissue, and finally, the internal lining of the blood vessels is another type of connective tissue made of smooth endothelial cells. The small capillaries are mostly just epithelial tissue. As you can see in this image, veins contain valves built of connective tissue that prevent blood from flowing backwards on its way to the heart. As you may have noticed in the models we've reviewed in this lesson, by convention, arteries are drawn red while veins are drawn blue. Many people misunderstand this to mean that human blood is red when it contains oxygen, as in most arteries, and blue when it's deoxygenated, as in most veins. This just isn't true. All human blood, in any form, is red. This image shows oxygenated blood on the left and deoxygenated blood on the right. As you can see, oxygen does make blood more vibrantly red, but the absence of oxygen just leaves blood a darker, duller red. When you look at blood vessels through your skin, they appear blue just because of the way light moves through your skin tissues above and around the blood vessels, and the way your eyes see color. Human blood just isn't ever blue. After analyzing the circulatory, aka cardiovascular system, we now understand that without this system, your cells wouldn't receive the nutrients they absolutely need to function. It's very important to keep your heart and blood vessels healthy and able to keep blood moving fluidly by staying active, avoiding smoking or vaping, eating healthy, and visiting the doctor every year to check your blood pressure and overall health. These habits and practices will also help keep the rest of your body healthy and functioning well. To conclude, let's check in with our learning objectives. How do our organs get the nutrients they need? How does blood receive nutrients for transport? How is blood moved throughout our body? If you're following along in your guided notes, pause this video to jot down your thoughts on these questions. Our organs get the nutrients they need from blood pumped by the heart, moving through veins to all the organs in the body. Blood picks up oxygen through capillaries around the alveoli of the lungs. Blood picks up nutrients from food through capillaries around the digestive system. Blood also picks up hormones from the organs that create them. Blood is moved from the heart to the rest of the body through arteries. This movement is accomplished by the heart muscle pumping. Blood moves back to the heart through the veins. The muscle in the veins themselves and in other parts of the body help the blood move back to the heart. Huzzah! We are learning things! In future lessons, we'll continue to unpack body systems. Now, go assess and expand your learning with the practice questions. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey, hey.